Subacromial impingement syndrome and rotator cuff tears are two of the most common conditions for the shoulder. And when we look at the treatment approaches for these conditions, there's a variety of different approaches that we can take, all the way from a conservative approach where we're looking at exercise and manual therapy, all the way up to more invasive approaches such as surgery, where we can do a decompressive surgery where we remove part of the acromion process that might be causing either the impingement or the rotator cuff tear. But when we look at the research, are conservative treatments or more invasive treatments better when it comes to outcomes looking at both of these conditions? When we look at the pathology of subacromial impingement and rotator cuff tears, they can be fairly similar. And so when we look at the structures, we have the acromion process which sits on top, and then the humeral head which is underneath. And then in between are a bursa and then also the supraspinatus tendon. And so one of the theories behind the development of subacromial impingement syndrome and or rotator cuff tears is that the acromion process can develop an osteophyte which sticks down into that subacromial space, and that can lead to compression and tearing of the supraspinatus tendon, and it can also lead to impingement because there's less space in between the acromion process and that humeral head. One of the other theories on how these develop is that there can actually be an issue with a rotator cuff. And so what happens with the rotator cuff is that it's not able to centrate that joint. And so what essentially happens is we have the glenoid process here and then the humeral head. And if the rotator cuff contracts, it keeps the head of the humerus centered in that glenoid fossa. But if it's not functioning properly, then we can have superior migration, which then leads to the humeral head hitting up against that acromion process, which can then lead to pain, and then also those bony osteophytes that form on the acromion process as a result of that compression of the humeral head against that acromion process. And so from a treatment perspective, it makes a lot of sense that if we have an osteophyte that's forming on the acromion process, which is either leading to subacromial impingement or rotator cuff tears, then we need to have surgery to remove that osteophyte so that way we can decrease the structural damage that's occurring to the rotator cuff and then also increase the space in that subacromial space so that we don't have impingement in between the acromion and the humeral head. And so there was a review article published in the Journal of Bone and Joint Surgery, and this was by Rossi and Ranalletta, which looked at subacromial decompressive surgery, which is where they remove part of the acromion process with either rotator cuff tears or for subacromial impingement syndrome. And what they found was that when they looked at subacromial impingement syndrome, there were several studies that found that there was no significant difference between groups that had subacromial decompression surgery compared to either non-operative active care such as exercise, or even compared to placebo surgery where they didn't actually remove any part of the acromion process. And this was true for both short-term and long-term follow-ups. And then when they looked at rotator cuff repairs and whether or not subacromial decompression surgery provided a better outcome, what they found was that for partial thickness rotator cuff tears, there's actually not that much research comparing the surgery with and without decompressive surgery. However, they did find one study which found that the partial rotator cuff repair was effective without the subacromial decompression surgery, and those participants were able to return to sport and have function in their shoulder, similar to what they had before their injury. For full thickness rotator cuff tears, there's actually quite a bit of research, and that research found that there was no significant difference when subacromial decompression surgery was included with a full thickness rotator cuff repair. The authors of the study concluded that there was substantial evidence that subacromial decompression surgery for the treatment of subacromial impingement syndrome did not provide any clinically significant benefit when looking at either functional outcomes or patient satisfaction when compared to active treatment or placebo. They also concluded that there was no significant difference for either clinical or structural outcomes in patients who were having their rotator cuff repaired and whether or not subacromial decompression surgery was included in the short term. And they did caution, though, for a type 3 acromion process, which is a little bit more of a hook type of structure, because there's just not that much research that's looked at type 3 acromion processes. And this brings up an interesting dilemma of how to apply this information clinically. Subacromial decompression surgery is a common procedure used to treat both subacromial impingement syndrome as well as rotator cuff tears. And like I said earlier, logically it makes sense that if you have an osteophyte that's protruding into that subacromial space, that you need to go in there surgically to remove that. Otherwise, it's always going to impinge on the rotator cuff or cause further damage to that rotator cuff. However, when we look at the research behind this procedure, it doesn't produce better outcomes either in the short term or long term when compared to non-operative care such as exercise. And so one of the questions that we really need to ask is, what does this procedure actually contribute to our treatment approach? When looking at the research, the osteophyte formation on that acromion process might not actually be the pain generator in these conditions. For example, when we look at subacromial impingement syndrome, when we look at those studies that do the subacromial decompression surgery compared to the sham surgery, so one group they remove the osteophyte and then the other group they do a fake surgery but they don't actually remove the osteophyte, the outcomes are similar in those two groups, which suggests that the osteophyte is not actually why these patients are improving after surgery. There's actually some interesting research when we look at subacromial impingement syndrome in that it's actually a tendon issue, and what happens is the supraspinatus tendon after loading swells, and that's actually what's decreasing the space in between the acromion process and the humeral head, and that leads to pain. And so it's actually the altered composition of the tendon and the swelling that happens after load. And so it takes longer to decrease the swelling and decrease the sensitivity of the tendon after loading. And so when we're looking at subacromial impingement syndrome, we need to load that supraspinatus tendon to get it to become stronger and be able to tolerate load better so that it doesn't swell and therefore produce pain. And then when looking at the rotator cuff, it's interesting because when we look at the location of the rotator cuff tears, they're typically not on top, which is where that osteophyte would actually cause damage to that supraspinatus tendon. They're typically either in the middle or on the bottom of that supraspinatus tendon. And so it's not the osteophyte that's actually causing the supraspinatus tendon tear. And so when looking at treatment, we would want to strengthen the supraspinatus and the rotator cuff as a whole. And we can also assess whether the scapula is contributing to the rotator cuff pain syndrome. So in summary, there's substantial evidence that subacromial decompression surgery does not produce any significant benefit when looking at the treatment of subacromial impingement syndrome or during rotator cuff repair, and that a non-operative approach, including exercise, will produce similar outcomes when looking at both short-term as well as long-term. Thank you for watching this video on subacromial decompression surgery for the treatment of subacromial impingement syndrome and rotator cuff repairs. I hope that you found this information useful. If you did, go ahead and give this video a big thumbs up. If you want to see more of my content, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. If you want to be notified of future videos, hit the bell icon as well. I'll see you guys in the next video.